Hi, I am Honza, and I am developer in virus lab department at Avast Software. And we are doing backend system for Virus Lab. Virus Lab is, generally speaking, we process 0.5 terabyte, 1 million samples every day, and our input is samples, and our output is detection, which we protect our users. Time between receiving sample and creating detection must be as short as possible. 1 million samples is a huge binary stream, and we need to analyze it very fast. We need scalable services where it's easy change, and we have tens of services, and we use many languages as C sharp, Perl, of course, Go, Scala, and all of the services must be monitorable and loggable. I am traditionalist, and I really like text logs in file. But if you have many services, it's really difficult to find the line which is where is the problem, and the log file. And this problem is getting worse when you introduce a new service. And we need some solution. And
okay. Ne, to jsou na tom disku.
OK. Můžeš jen kouknout. Ne. OK. This solution is Greylog. It's open source. Central logging open source software, and okay. Yeah, I need images, sorry.
To nebylo totiž. Dokud na Windowsu to funguje, a tady ne. Velký to nebylo. Ale... A můžeš to vyšší?
OK, sorry. I create this slides on Windows, and Windows is case insensitive, and this is Linux, and this is case sensitive, and my images, some have PNG with big charts, and some I fix it, and with, because I have really cool images, and I need it. Okay. Yeah, Greylog have some cool features like search on dashboards, monitoring and alerting streams of logs, and many, a couple of inputs like TCP, UDP, Kafka, or AMQP. And you can send via GELF, it's Greylog extended log format, or can use syslog and or plain text. And the syntax search, search of syntax is very close to Lucene because Greylog use Elasticsearch backend. Yeah. Greylog syntax is simple. This is really easy, simple. If you need all logs on server a.domain.com, you write this. And if you need all errors logs, you write level It's a syslog specification. Okay, Greylog supports full text search. You can see it's really fast because as 30 days, in full text, we'll search it in 8 seconds. Okay, we have logs from application and we need some numbers. How many requests is to our application? Is our infrastructure sufficient, or we need more servers? How often our application died and others? We need metrics and we need monitoring. We use Graphite and StatSite for monitoring. StatSite is C implementation of StatsD, is smaller and faster. Application sends metrics to StatSite, and StatSite collects the metrics and periodically flashes aggregated metrics to Graphite. CollectD collects system metrics like CPU, memory, and sending this aggregated data to Graphite. This image describes how store Graphite values, and values is stored in fixed size window structure similar as RRD. If you send value in the same time window in same interval, the previous value is lost. If you send in first interval is 5, in second interval you send 3 and 7, and we save only 7. In this interval we send nothing and it's 0, and in this interval we send 8 and 4, and we store 4. And yeah, this is reason why we use StatSite. Okay. The flash interval of StatSite and time window size must be same. Okay, dot is delimiter. And you can imagine a folder in matrix tree, like slash is separate folders in file system tree. And we have convention name for our keys. First is service, second is application or component of microservice, and next is server, and last is metric itself. Okay, this first is example of some counter key. Application name is YAPSI example app, host name is my host, and metric itself is request IP count. Timer example is you send this time to StatSite, and StatSite generate histogram with this matrix. And for example, P95 is percentile. Okay. This is graphite UI. It works, supports moving and joining graph, etc. But it's a little bit ugly. This is the reason why we are using Grafana. Grafana UI is another UI for Graphite. Graphite API returns metrics, series, and Grafana visualize them. Well, this is simple query to Graphite. Okay, in the chart we can see the count of connection of our submit gateway. And first U is star. Star is placeholder to all metrics in current folder. We can see there is an application called submit, and it's running on three servers, three lines, three cores. And the graph show the number of connections each server received. If we want to see how many connections are on the server and total, we switch to stack view. Okay, you see it's total count of connection, and we can see rate between servers. And alias by node is puts the name of servers to the legend. Okay, this is a little bit complex query. Okay, this we sum all metrics in the first wildcard in this star. It's application servers are like aux1, aux2, and etc. And this star, it's a servers which reporting this matrix, and this servers we can see and visualize. And Graphite have a really big set of function, and this is link of manual of this function to get. And if you have nice dashboards, you can visualize on big screen like we do in Virus Lab. It's a Virus Lab control center, like NASA have mission control center. Okay, alerting. We have metrics, and we can see if something goes wrong if we watch the metrics. And we want to automate checking the metrics. We need some tool which watch and send an email if something goes wrong. We need alerting. We use Siren tool. It's simple, maybe too much simple, but works. And you can define your query to Graphite, and if it's threshold crossed, then it alerts via email or Slack or etc. Some alerting tools, which I know, it's And it's possible we use this stack. For example, Banshee is anomalies detection system for periodic metrics. Or Grafana, new version has support of alerting and its experimental bug looks very promising. Okay. Some examples. Well, I have simple REST application which process some posted file. And I need to monitor this application. Okay. Boom. Well, I create instance of net statside client and set statside host and prefix for my metrics. Sorry? Děkuju. Můžu čas? Okay. Okay. It's no time. Oh, well, I add incrementer, some I increment errors and sorry, conclusion. Yeah. For monitoring, we use netstatside client, which is now in on CPAN. It's my first release module, and statside and graphite stack. Graphite doesn't have nice UI. Use Grafana UI, and it's a little better. For alerting, we use Siren. It works, but I hope Grafana alerting will be better. And for logs, we use Greylog and OwnLogDispatch Gelf module, which is on CPAN. Okay. Question? No. Thank you.